there's a special kind of sensation that we get when we get go to a traditional ghat. We all must have already been to Arighat or Pashupatinath or the ghat in Sankhamur or the one in Paramdip. There's some character, there's some sensation that we get when we go around those ghats, and that is because of, not only because of the physical characters that we get in those ghats, like the platform, the steps that lead to the river, the inland stone that is called the Brahmana. These are only the physical characters, but the cultural aspect and the social aspect related to ghat and cremation is something that gives the ghat a character. And becoming interested in that character, I took this this topic. Crematorium is basically a place where a body is cremated, that is burned to ashes to dispose it of. And there are different types of crematoriums, like the one we have in Nepal, the traditional one. There are some modified traditional ones as well, something that is operated with gas or electrical. When I looked into the literature of cremation, I found that it is not only one act of burning a death, but something that comes before and after it. Like, if you are willing to give up your life to the God, and you see in the lap of God, that is called in hospice centers, that comes before death, that is acceptance of death. When death happens, the whole society comes and carries the body to the ghat. That is during after immediately after the death. When it reaches the ghat, there is the act of cremation. That is the main act in this whole process. When the cremation is done, the ashes are deposited off into the river. And after that, there is also 13 days of mourning. This is especially in the case of Hindu, which is the major focus of my thesis. Similarly, there are other psychological and psychological aspects related to the sorrow and mourning of death of someone near and there. So when I did this research, I was really curious to know how cremation is being performed in different parts of the world. So for that, I looked into the case studies of from Nepal and different other places. My primary focus was Arighat, but that was my that came into my literature. So I focused more on the modern expression of cremation. So for that, the local one, the only electrical crematorium in Nepal is the Pashupatinath Arighat. I looked into it and I found that the spaces like front porch, which is semi open, are really interesting and is rich for these kind of purposes. Also, I found that the circulation was linear in Pashupatinath, and that is something that hindered me because I could see the dead body being burned from outside. Similarly, the next case studies I took were from India, and these are truly modern expression of architecture. One of them is Mahaprasthanam in Hyderabad, which expresses the different expression, different feelings of the people through the form of the building. And this is really close to what I wanted to do. It is minimal and goes blends with the surrounding. The third one is Ashwini Kumar, that is in Surat, and this is actually an electrical crematorium. And this is actually a gas crematorium. And something really interesting about this is that they have focused more on circulation, so that when one family injures, they do not interact with another family who is returning after the cremation. So these are some interesting case studies that I did, and I wanted to find a site that is relevant to my thesis, what I wanted to show. And all of those characters are seen in rich ghats of Kathmandu and some around Kathmandu, but then the modern ghats are being constructed outside the valley. So I wanted the site which is outside the valley and which has a existing ghat, so that there is no drastic social change that I bring through my project. So in that search I found Kaltemai ghat, which is when you go to the eastern Nepal, on the east-west highway, after crossing the longest bridge of Nepal, the Ganga Bridge, you find one ghat that is on the left of the road, and this is my site. So this is the Ganga ghat. So talking about the context of my site, it has a really rich immediate context. For that matter, this is the east-west highway, and the site is little split bit down from there. This is the Kankai River, and there's a community forest, right? It's called the Kankai community forest here, and there's a dham, Kotiyom dham here. So this is a really rich site. Including this, there's existing two temples in the site, which are all a part of the existing ghat that are present in the site itself. Then I looked into the traditional architecture of the whole surrounding. As we all know, there's no public public vernacular architecture in Nepal, so I looked into the private ones. So I found the tari ghars, where the houses are raised above the floor to prevent different threats like the flood or the insects and the wild animals. The good thing about this site is that it is located well away from the settlement, which is 1 to 2 kilometers from Surunga, or 800 meters after this river is another small settlement. So I took this site. Through all this, I had to develop a concept to guide the design. For that, through all the inferences, I found that the number 5 is really dominant in the whole process, where a person who is going through mourning phase is mostly affected by 5 different senses. The other elements, when a person is really sad, all the physical necessities are to the minimum, and all the psychological things affect them, and that is experienced through 5 senses. So 5 senses is there. Also, it's said that the human body is made up of 5 different elements, and a person dying is a part of the cycle of that 5 different elements going back to the nature. There's also 5 different ritual stages, that is awaiting the journey to the cremation itself, the Antyeshti and the Kriya. Also, there are, according to psychology, there are 5 different recovery stages. So all of these come together to form something that is called the 5th dimension of spirituality, that is the highest level of consciousness that a human being can achieve through the environment. So this was my final goal. So my dominant character from the concept is the 5 different elements, and for that I wanted to bring all of those elements into my site, and for that I had 5 elements. So through this I found that the modernization of cremation is through electrical crematorium. So I brought the 5 elements into the heart of my site through electrical crematorium. After that, there's water element. Water is a crucial part of the whole cremation process. But then when I looked into the case study of Pashupatinath, I found that the electrical crematorium was really far away from the water. So I tried to bring the water into the site so that all those activities come to the core of the site as well. After that, there's earth and ether. Earth and ether is being used as the material. That is the whole wall. Everything is made out of earth plaster. The structure had to be something strong, so I used a steel structure. So something like this. The character of the whole architecture is given by the material, that is earth. Finally, air element. I'd like to explain this in my form development, because I use this. For the form development, I looked into the pyre system, because this is a site where it's really hot and humid, and it's really difficult to get the site, whole site cooled down, and especially the landscape, because that is where most of the people gather around. So when I studied this site, I found that the air movement was from northeast to southwest. So this was the existing site, air passage. And I wanted to orient all of my buildings so that I create a gap, and that allows the air movement to go through the site. So for that, I looked into the pyre system, where the logs are placed on one on top of another, and the same pattern is replicated in the form, and so that the whole air passes through my site and cools down my site itself. So this is the process, and I came up with a conceptual 3D. So for implementing this, I want to keep it really linear and simple, so that it doesn't affect the psychology of the people coming here. So for that, I developed a modular system of 10 by 10 grid, and all of these blocks and spaces are arranged in that grid. So this is how my form came out to be, and to understand how my design is, how my blocks are oriented, I want to I want you to step into the shoes of five different type of people who come may come to my side. Let's start from one who come to burn someone who is dear to them. So this is the main entrance that is really close to the highway. The highway links to the road here. You come through the gate from the security guard post. After that, as you can see in the master plan, this is a common community plaza that is really vibrant and rich. And you can also see something that is straight and dark and cozy in some way. A straight path leading to somewhere you don't know because it curves from there. So you are compelled to take that path. So you come from here. And somebody from your family goes to the administration because that is the nearest building that you see there. This is the administration, this is the entrance. So you come here, do your registration. So when you come from there, you do you go to the reception and do the registration, you record your death. And all of those, staffs, stay inside and your work is done here only. So you come out from here. The main Malami, they take the bath, and when I listen to the Garud Puran, it says that the Malami has to find a midpoint of the whole journey to the ghat and have to rest there and give pindal once at that time. So for that, I use the existing tree of the site to create a chautara so that the people can get a place to rest. After this, I decided to use one block that is really close to the chautara where there are shops, so that when people are there resting there, they can be well aware about, they can take some time and then decide to buy some stuff that they require for permission. So the shop block is here. After that, you have a choice. You can either opt for the more modern electrical crematorium or the traditional ones. So you have two different pathways. If you go ahead on the same path, you reach to the ghat. And there, that's where the traditional crematorium is, and this has this existing the traditional character to it. That's the steps, the Brahmanal and the pyres. Right now, I've given four different pyres, four different platforms. Two of them are covered, and for that, when the body is burning there, they can the people mourners can come here and sit in the seats, or if the day is good, they can sit in the stairs as well. So if you someone there is willing to have an idea of donating their organs before that, they can do that in the organ donation that is accessible from here. So if not, you cremate the dead, and after that you can follow this path. You can follow this path and then exit through the exit here. So that is one case. And if you want to burn your death in dead in electric crematorium, what you do is from the chautara you take the ramp up, reach to this block, and from there you do your rituals in on the side of the canal.
Can you please explain on the model?
Sure. So you come up, you come to this block, and then do your rituals on the side of the canal where it is similar to this. And after that, you
artificially are doing the work.
Yes, exactly. So you do all the rituals. It's new. So you do all the rituals there. But then the interesting part is that the electrical furnaces are not in the same level. It's below the ground level. That is done because most of the people who opt for electrical crematorium are the people who have transferred from the ones who bury their deaths. And I wanted them to pay a homage to those kind of people so that they have a similar kind of feeling and they go below the ground level and then reach to a point which has a sunken courtyard and electrical furnaces halls in the side. So you cremate your dead here. Put them into the furnaces. You come out. You sit for a while. And one interesting part of this place is that you can see in the section. So this is the central courtyard. There's a water wall here. When there's a ghat and you are burning your death, there's one feeling of listening and smelling the water, which is lost in electrical crematorium. And this is what I wanted to regenerate in this part. So you have this water wall here so that you can listen to the water. And when all of this is done, you follow the same path, you come out and go through the exit. That is one case. Next is that...
I didn't get the electrical furnace. How it is done? You go down?
Yeah, through the ramp.
After this Brahmanal, this feeling?
This is the Brahmanal.
Okay.
Use the rituals here. From the ramp, you go down, reach to this point, and then do the... keep your bell in the furnaces. And you can either come out or sit
not the furnace. You keep the entrance of the furnace. You keep it in the trolley. The trolley goes to the furnace.
Yes. This is the trolley. And you push the trolley from there, and it goes to this furnace. And there are
why is this in the inclined way? Why that is like a car parking?
That has a reason, because when you cremate your dead, you have to orient their head towards the north. And since all of my blocks are oriented in the air direction, in the airflow, wind flow direction, I could not orient this one block inclined. So what I decided to do was something that is more flexible, is the partition. And I decided to incline those furnaces towards the north.
This is not. For that magnetic knot, you are making that.
Yes. Similar to the guards. Okay. So, another part of my so that is one of the type of people who use my site. Another is, so as I said earlier, that it covers all the function that is related to before cremation and after cremation. So this hospice as well, hospice that is in front of this electrical crematorium over here, and this is something that faces the dham, so that the people resting there, they can have a clear visual of the dham area. And hospice is a place where there are actually two different kinds of hospices. One is where people have a certain medical situation where they are not. They have a chronic disease and are sure to die, and they go there to stay for the final days of their life. There's another kind of hospice where people have accepted that they are about to die because of the age, and they want to give the final days to the God, in the service of the God. So they stay in some places near to the dham area or religious area. So this is something that covers both of them.
Is it prevailing right now in this time also? Previously, yes, in old days, in the last part of the life, where they think that the parents or the family members, they think that it is the last time, so we take them to the ghat, okay? And their ghat also, the old times, the ghatibai day were used to be there, and they said, okay, two more days, we can wait, and like that, so instead of keeping in the ghat, you keep in the room where that hospital. Not the hospice where the hospital is.
Yeah.
This is a different hospice. Right?
Yes.
So is it prevailing right now? I don't know.
Actually,
now what happens is, instead of that, people, they take to the hospital. When they declare that it is dead, one day they take to the doctor.
Yeah, and that is the exact point of time that I want to capture, because the people who are already about to die, they are not kept in the hospital, and people not. They don't want to keep them with the sorrow of the family members in their home. So this is the perfect place between those two points, the death and the hospital.
Is it prevailing right now? I don't know that area.
Yeah, actually, I went to a Vridhashram around, and I found that a lot of people there were like...
Vridhashram is there, okay. Yeah. Vridhashram is there, hospital is there, clinics are there. There are a lot of things where the people are dying at the last. Not all at the home itself.
Yeah.
Okay? So one is this area, crematorium or cremation center. One is the people, they take the body, not for the basis who is going to die. Okay? So I don't know whether that is prevailing in that. That's why I'm asking you. If it is still prevailing in the society over there.
No,
I don't know.
hospice is one of my So for the hospice, what you do is, let me explain for the model itself. So you come from the same entrance, you come to the parking, and this is the entrance of the hospice. You can see it directly from the parking. The entrance is wide and open. So from there, you go, you enter to the hospice. And inside the hospice, what you have is a reception area, a place to kind of a lounge where the guests are welcome to visit their family if they are staying there. And all the units are all private areas, so they are segregated from this public area. So there are different kinds of units. One of them has seven different rooms. So unit one has seven rooms. There are toilets for all of them. There's also the meditation room for the people who want to have medicines given to them on timely basis. There's also a caretaker room, one on this floor and one on the other floor, on the top floor. So to go to the top floor, you have three different ways. You can either take the lift or the two different stairs that are there. On upper floor, there are two different types.
Ramp or stair? Ramp or stair.
No, sir. I have a lift for the accessibility.
When they are serious and people are like, you need a stretcher to get.
Yeah, actually.
Or you need a long lift, yes, of course.
Yeah.
Hospital lift, like.
Hospital lift, yeah. So on the upper floor, there are other different special kind of units that is used for medical hospice, that is for medical equipment. So there's enough room for them. And all of them have their own balcony so that they can have a private time on their balcony or a common terrace where they can come together and talk to one another. So there's this social kind of this relationship established. If there are...
Who is going to talk to each other? The patients, the dying people or the...
Yeah, maybe the dying people, because there's a kind of a feeling where everybody is about to die, let's celebrate it together, so something like this.
They will go back to home instead.
Okay, and there's another one where if the people are poor and they want to share the room, they can do that in these kind of joint areas. For the dining and dining kitchen, for this, it is combined with the overall canteen of the home site, that's for the staff. And on the upper floor, which connects to the hospice center, there's dining for the people. Actually, they get delivered their food in the rooms, but if they want to, they can come here and have lunch and dinner. Something that is interesting in hospice center is that people don't want to go out of the place. They don't want to come into the place through the same place where the dead is being taken out. So I've created a different exit for the people who have already died. Who are dead from the hospice center. So, they exit from here. So that is another kind of people who use my, and it is like this. You can come to the ghat from there. So this is another kind of people who come to my site. Another is the 13-day kriya people. So this is the kriya bond, and this is kept separate from all of this build structure, because these are the people who are not allowed to touch other people while they are there for the morning. So they have this exit doubles as the entry for Kriya Bhavan. It has its own parking, and there are two different types of units. Four on the ground floor. There are four different units on the ground floor. You come to the administration, and there's a feast hall for 13th day feast. And on the upper floor, there are two larger units for a bigger family. And all of them have separate rooms for male, female, and gorta, and also a food preparation zone, and also a semi-open outdoor space that is for the havan and all the puja that they do there. So after that,
we can take some extra because we get disturbing.
So after that, there's another part to it. If you are running a crematorium like this, you also have to think about the people who work there. So if you are a worker in this place, what you do? You enter from the same place. This is one of the places where the workers are concentrated. This is the administration building. So And as I talked earlier about, the administrative building is here, and you have all the things that you require, that is the staff room, the meeting room, the foyer, the chairman sits in his own office, there's also toilets here, and everything is there, and you have some trees, sign of life inside this. So everything that is deadly outside, that is sorrowful outside, you have something to cheer about inside. So that is administration. And if you are a worker in some other place, you scatter from the same place. That is, you go to the either to the canteen or to the shop or to the cremation like this. So that's the way that you want to go take the staff's tour. The final one is you are a visitor to this place, or you stay somewhere around and you want to go there in the times of evenings and mornings. So what I have created is a community space that is incorporating the existing temple, and I wanted to create some open areas so that people can sit there for bhajan and everything. So maybe also to stroll in the evening. So for that, they have this area where there's also a library here, a small library that is dedicated to only small spiritual books that you can find there and read it in the place itself. Or if one of the trending things nowadays is the aarti thing in the evening. So I separated this area for the evening aarti so that people can come here and they can see the aarti being going on. And the aarti platform is there, the black one is the aarti platform, so that people, the main pujari faces the river to do the aarti. So this is how all of my site is being organized. And there are small details that I really wanted to explore and express through my design. One of them is the canal. The canal, it goes through the heart of the site. And also one of the platforms in the hospice center, that's the meditation platform, where it is surrounded by kundas, and you can find a way of feel something like a floating, that your body is floating over the water in these kind of platforms that is here. And there's also the steps that can be used to sit down. So on these places you can sit down there as well. There's also the water wall that I said earlier, and there are places like this where if you are going through the electrical to the park of electrical crematorium, you see the water from this gap inside which is in the horizon, and you feel that you are going to cremate somebody. There's also the pyre that I have oriented differently in here. One is to orient it to the north, and another is to solve the problem of pollution. That is, when the deaths are cremated, the remaining timbers are thrown directly into the river, and that pollutes the river itself. So what I wanted to do was create a small change in the design. Small change in the design where there's a chamber here, and you push the unburnt logs, and it stays there. Somebody can, at the end of the day, somebody can come through the steps, or from here they can pull this off and take it somewhere else. And the reason I did this is because I found that on the site they take these unburnt logs from downstream and they use it to burn as a fuel somewhere after drying it out. So why not do it in the site itself? So this is one of my expression of some details that I want to express to my design. So finally, what I wanted to do in the initial phase of my project is to create a crematorium that is not something imitated from outside, and that is not only a cement platform, a concrete platform on the side of the river. And I wanted everything, every rituals, every aspect of Nepali lifestyle to be incorporated into this, and came up with this project that is actually a crematorium of Nepal. Thank you.